Hi, I'm the Warrior Witch, and you can call me Nike. Today is gonna have some spicy hot takes, so strap in and get ready, cause some of y'all ain't gonna like what I say. Today's topic is all about research, as I'm sure you guessed by the title. We're gonna be talking about how to find information, how to find good information, and how to know what is bad information. I wanna begin with why research is so important. Research is the foundation of witchcraft. We are constantly learning and using our information that we find. My first spicy hot take is, if you don't like research, you shouldn't be a witch. And no, I'm not joking. If you like crystals, or you like oils, or yoga, or meditation, but you don't really like the research aspect of the rest of witchcraft, that's fine. You can just do those things. You can be just into those things. But if you don't like research, you shouldn't be a witch. You have to research plants and spells and crystals and all sorts of other things. I mean, the list is kind of endless, and that's why witchcraft is so fun, is you get to learn all the time. That's my Gemini coming out, of course. You get to learn all the time, and you're always expanding your knowledge base. You're always expanding the things you can do and the things you can use. That's why I love it so much. But if you don't like it, maybe witchcraft isn't for you. Maybe you just practice meditation, maybe you just practice with crystals. But to call yourself a witch is to call yourself the eternal student. So with that spicy take out of the way, where do you start? Some of you also might not like this answer, but for different reasons. I say start in secular resources. Now, for those who don't know what the word secular means, that basically is anything outside of spirituality or religion. Scientific resources are the main thing you'll find included when people say the word secular. And for me, for witchcraft, the secular sources I like to look at are things like geology, history, geography, foraging guides, things like that. That information is going to be really important to you. Yes, the magic is all fun, the witchcraft is all fun, but the important thing to remember is that it's all based in reality, in real things that exist on this planet that have real properties. If you want to learn about a plant, learn where it grows and why it grows there, why it grows that way, what varieties of that plant exist, what it's used for, the chemical composition that comes with any of it. For example, foxglove. The Latin name of foxglove is digitalis. Digitalis is also the name of a heart medication. The heart medication gets its name from the flower. One of the many correspondences that go along with foxglove is love, and we had that correspondence long before we had the medication digitalis. It's associated with love and the heart, but digitalis also physically affects the heart. It is technically a poison, and like many things, medicine can be made from poisonous materials, but that type of poison affects your heart, it affects your cardiac system, and doctors have found a way to use it in a way that can help your heart. So in that way, science and magic work together. As I cover a lot in my videos, science also helps keep you safe. Let's go with crystals. Certain crystals are going to be toxic if you put them in water or if you combine them with the wrong things. Like selenite. I've covered selenite before. It'll dissolve in water. Malachite is toxic in water. You have to know how things react, what they're made of, and what that thing reacts with in order to know how to keep yourself safe. Once you have a good basis in secular knowledge, I would say then move on to witchy things. Start with books, that's what I like to say, because they are a physical resource you can hold in your hands and flip to that page easily, you can make notes on it. Books are great. Books can also be really bad, because anybody can write a book, especially these days. Anybody can publish a book, because self-publishing is easier than ever before. With any resource, book or otherwise, it applies to everything, but especially with books. Cross-reference the information that you have inside and make sure you learn about the author. Who are they? How long have they been practicing? What is their field of expertise? Is their job as a professional witch or a professional version of a form of witchcraft, like astrology? What kinds of things do they practice? Are they a Wiccan? That's going to color how they give you the information because their views are going to be based in whatever they believe. And here's the biggest thing. Do they cite their sources? There are some books out there that are notorious for not citing their sources. if you know, you know. Some sources that I really love are people like Cunningham, who has a laundry list of things in his bibliography that he has sourced from that he can point you to as well, and you can see where he got his information. You can cross-reference with things that aren't on his bibliography to see how well that matches up outside of the things that he referenced. You also need to cross-reference information because, let's say someone wrote a book, and in that book they talk about runes. If a 5-minute Google search can give you the answer that the information in there is incorrect, maybe it's not the best source to use. Always cross-reference your information. Just because someone wrote a book doesn't mean they're right. They could have misinformation that someone that they trusted taught to them that is wrong. Maybe they just don't care enough to search the information. Maybe they're trying to use their gut on a topic that using your gut doesn't work for. Either way, no matter what the situation, you need to make sure that that information is correct before you use it. We also live in the information age. It is easier than ever before in history to find information online. It literally takes typing in a word and Google. No, that's not it. It literally takes typing in a word and witchcraft. That's it. You could look up rose quartz witchcraft, selenite witchcraft, cinnamon witchcraft, salt witchcraft. I mean, literally anything you could think of, type that into Google and witchcraft, and you will find ways it can be used in witchcraft and the things it corresponds to. You could type in cinnamon witchcraft correspondences and get the information you're looking for. It really is that simple. A lot of people seem to think that if they just ask somebody else, they'll give them all the answers. But going back to, if you don't like research, you shouldn't be a witch, it's not that hard to research. It's really not. I mean, maybe you don't like that answer because you've struggled to find stuff in the past, but it really isn't hard. Especially when you have so many people out here telling you their favorite resources, telling you the places that they learned their information. Which brings me to my next point. Book recommendations online. A lot of prominent people on social media in the witch space, especially on YouTube, will often have book recommendations or book reviews. Look at the people that have those out there and look at the things that they recommend to you. Look at reasons why they like those books, because usually they'll give reasons. They won't just say, oh, it's a good book. They'll say the information in it was really helpful. They go really in depth in this or that topic. Look at the things that they recommend and look at why. But even with that, just because your favorite YouTuber in the witchy space likes a book also doesn't mean that that book is correct. Go back to cross-reference that information. Look at it again. Look at somewhere else that is not that source, that is not that author, that is not someone that that author recommends, and see how well it matches up still. I'll give a quick example of a book I really love. I have two books. On my bookshelf back here, I have Grove Daughter Witchery and Astrology for Real Relationships. Grove Daughter Witchery is sort of no-nonsense in its approach to witchcraft and even includes a section all about fire safety that is basically how not to burn down your house while trying to do witchcraft. They have information about, for example, if you burn rosemary, it will flake off. So if you are burning it for cleansing, you want to hold it over a bowl while it burns so you don't burn your house down with the embers falling onto the ground, like onto carpet or a blanket. Astrology for Real Relationships is written by Jessica Lignato, and she also has a no-nonsense approach to her astrology. She has a podcast that first turned me onto her content, which inspired me enough to actually buy a book, which I don't do a lot. Books are expensive, and if I bought every one that I wanted, I would have no money forever. But her podcast is very no-nonsense, and it's based in reality. She doesn't try to fluff things up. She tells you, look, sometimes things are gonna be hard, and we can just use this as a guide to look both within ourselves and at the world, at the things going on around us, and to try to plan for things, to try to prepare and take advantage of the energy that's around us. She doesn't make it seem like everything's going to be okay because this planet is trine with this planet and your chart is so amazing. She tells you, like, yeah, this is a difficult aspect in your chart, or yeah, this is a difficult aspect for the world to go through right now. But she also then gives advice on how to deal with that. I also really love her book because when it says real relationships, it doesn't just mean your romantic relationships. The relationships she includes are, I'm gonna read straight from the book so I can get the phrasing correct. She includes friends and chosen family, hanging out and dating, and long-term relationships. So any definition of the word relationship is included in this book. I'll do a more full book recommendation video in the future, but for now, those are my top two that I have immediately around me that are a great example of books I love and why I love them. I want to take a moment to talk about less than stellar resources that are not just misinformation, but straight up dangerous. A lot of the witch space also happens to fall into things that are, let's say, less than scientific in a very different way from your typical witchcraft thing. Unfortunately, some of witchcraft leads people to conspiracy theories. And if you ever hear anyone start spouting out conspiracy theories like, the moon is hollow.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
They are not someone you should listen to when it comes to witchcraft and spirituality. Ever. And I mean that. But when someone tries to deny science, that's when I get mad. I don't know who put it this way. It might be the Witch of Wonderlust on YouTube, who I love, by the way, but I don't remember for sure. So if it's not Olivia, congrats Olivia, I'm giving you credit. But there's a quote I really love that is, witchcraft is just science we haven't explained yet. If you're out here denying science, you have no place in the witchy space, in my opinion. Because all of what we do has a scientific basis. All of what we know has a scientific basis. Tinctures and potions? That turn into modern day medicine. Herbal remedies turn into modern day medicine. All of our basis is in science at the end of the day. My final spicy take is, unfortunately, not everyone in the witchcraft community wants what's best for you. Some of them only want what's best for themselves, and sometimes that includes attention or money, and they'll do anything they can to get that from you, even if it takes lying. Please be careful when you're looking at information. Please be careful when you're looking at sources. Cross-reference it. Check on their history. Check their sources, if they even have them at all, because that's a big red flag. Keep yourself safe, and keep your basis in science. Understand the reality and the roots of everything, where it comes from, folklore, history, geology, everything. Understand that you're a real physical person living in the real physical world, and you can't change that, so try to understand it. That's it for me this week. I'll see you guys next time. And blessed be.